My name is Kay Kudlacek, and I was diagnosed with atrial fibrillation when I was 43 years old. My husband and I were very active in everything we did in our lives, very active with work, very active in the community. We like to travel a lot. We like to be outdoors and do a lot of things outdoors. The atrial fibrillation really changed that for me.
Atrial fibrillation is the most common electrical problem that people will develop. It's associated with a chaotic electrical rhythm in the top chambers of the heart. And the result is that the heart rate is accelerated and irregular. The performance of the heart is diminished.
My atrial fibrillation started by just feeling kind of a blip, a real rapid heartbeat and a regular heartbeat, and only maybe for just a few seconds. It got to be a little bit worse as far as lasting for a longer period of time. I would have these episodes where I could feel my heart beating irregularly for anywhere up to 4 to 6 hours every day. And it was both physically and mentally draining for me. It was hard to concentrate, hard to do anything.
You can think of it as if your heart is trying to run a marathon day after day. So you feel like you've run a marathon even though you've gone about your daily activities normally. And I think in Kay's case, the lightheadedness and headache were major complications of the problem.
My first cardiologist was with another hospital, and we got to a point where we knew that the medications that I was on weren't really working, and my atrial fibrillation was actually just getting worse. He actually referred me to another cardiologist to talk about the next steps. And to be honest with you, I wasn't really impressed with this doctor. I was actually just telling a coworker, a friend of mine at work, about my situation, and he referred me to Dr. Faddis. I did go online to the internet, and I did a search for any information about him. Once we read more about even Dr. Faddis, we were just instantly impressed with his credentials.
When Kay came to me, she fit right into that tradition of taking patients who have failed traditional therapies that are readily available, and was looking at sort of the cutting edge of what we could do to help her.
Really gave me a high comfort level. And made the decision a lot easier to want to go ahead with the catheter ablation procedure, knowing that he would be the one performing the procedure.
The ablation catheter has a specialized electrode that applies electrical current. So it creates a little burn, kind of like a spot weld. And by doing that in sequence, you can create a line, a fence around those problem areas. And it takes about 3 to 4 hours to establish that perimeter. And then over the course of about 3 months, that place that we've created by catheter ablation becomes a permanent scar that will protect against that atrial fibrillation from entering out into the heart. We work as a team and are committed to understanding what the next step is to enhance this. So all patients that we see get the advantage of the latest techniques and technology.
I knew that it was the right decision that I made, and I really didn't have any doubts about the procedure itself or the doctor who was going to perform it. I really had all the confidence in the world in Dr. Faddis.
It's a high volume center, and I think that's critical because each member of the team that helps us with this, from the nurses, the staff, the technicians, we all have to be very accustomed to a complex procedure that happens on a daily basis, and that helps us do it effectively.
I can honestly say that I don't have any AFib, which is like night and day compared to before. I mean, I didn't realize how miserable I was and how awful I felt until now, when I don't feel like that anymore. And I really feel like I got my life back.